Volume 2 has just come out. You have this immense catalog of music that you guys put together. There's depth to it now that even you are realizing that a lot of us think we saw right off the beginning. Any chance that you might step on stage with them at some point?
There you go, Joe. I knew you were going to go there.
I want to say
I know, but it's a valid question, for Christ's sake. I understand that, and I don't fault you for that. It's a tough one. I don't think so, because I think we're all in different places, though. I think we were great together when we were together back in the day when music was different and our lives were different. And you know, they have gone their way and I've gone mine, and they're doing really well with their singer they have now. And I'm living my life, and they're doing what they feel is right. I'm doing what I feel is right. And I think we just kind of have to leave it alone. But I want to just say one thing. Before you move on, I do want to say that I know deep down that we do love each other. I mean, we may not like each other that much, but I really believe in our hearts that we do love each other, because we were in this mission together. Nobody really knows what it's like when a band bands together to become something bigger than the individual parts could ever conceive. And when you're in that mission together, you're in the trenches and you're traveling daily, you're busting your butt and you're doing all this stuff together. You get on each other's nerves, but you accomplish together things you can't do alone. And so, you know, I know that deep down the glue that held us together, though we may not have shown it to each other, I've come to believe that the glue that held us together is that we had a deep love for each other and each other's musical talents. The bad side is that we damaged each other, so we have problems, mm-hmm. as all relationships, by the way, mm-hmm. do. And so it isn't that we don't, I think, deeply love each other. I just don't think we like each other that much, but we appreciate each other. And I must say, I, more than ever now, listening to these tracks on this greatest hits, to have a deeper appreciation than ever before.
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere. A singer in a smoky room, the smell of wine and cheap perfume. For a smile they can share the night. It goes on and on.
Living just to find emotion.
journey, Don't Stop Believin', from the remastered Greatest Hits Volume 1. Steve Perry's building a home studio where he plans to keep working on new music. He has over 50 songs in development and has even recorded a Beatles cover, which he hopes to release soon. Off the Record was written and produced by Stacey Farah. Production and engineering by Ron Harris, assisted by Ted Woods. Special thanks to Nate Potker. And a big thank you to Steve Perry for taking the time to chat. The newly remastered for vinyl edition of Journey's Greatest Hits Volume 2 is out now. It's been released on 180-gram virgin vinyl, and it sounds great. I'm Joe Benson. You can email me at UncleJoe@UncleJoe.com. And I'll see you next time for Bob Seger, Off the Record on the Dial Global Radio Networks.
Campbell County, East Tennessee, and the world.
Via WQLA.